next up is a company called Biocept. It's ticker BIOC on the NASDAQ. And we have here the president and CEO of Biocept. It's Mike Nall. Mike, there he is.
Hi there. How are you doing?
I'm doing very well today. I will let you have the floor. You have a very nice looking office there, and I can see your slides. So it looks like we are all good to go.
Yeah, sounds good. Well, we're excited to be here and tell the story of Biocept, where we're delivering personalized medicine through this idea of a liquid biopsy. And before I get started, though, I'll go ahead and go over our forward-looking statements and encourage you to review the filings that we have at the SEC and assess the risks of investing in our company. So at Biocept, we're making a huge difference for patients diagnosed with cancer. And we've got patented technology that can isolate actual cancer cells or cancer DNA out of a fluid sample. Now, one of the big differences of Biocept's ability to do that is that we target not just blood, like some other labs do, but we also can access this material out of cerebral spinal fluid. So it's interesting with the previous presentation I just saw, talking a little bit about spinal cord, and where CSF is the fluid that surrounds your spinal cord and your brain. And this is important for patients that are diagnosed with cancer because about 10 to 30% of the time, depending on the type of cancer, that cancer can metastasize and spread to the central nervous system brain. So at Biocept, we're focused on helping those patients live longer lives. In addition, an important aspect of our company is that to assist in the pandemic, we started offering COVID testing last summer, and that's grown to be a very large part of our business and helping pay the bills for the investments we're making in our oncology program. So, highlights of investment in our company, well, we're focused on high unmet clinical needs. So this focus on patients who are diagnosed with cancer and identifying patients whose cancer has spread to the central nervous system and the brain is really unique to Biocept and important to understand. This is a very large market called liquid biopsy, $17 billion plus, according to analysts, and in fact, growing as more and more technologies, more and more assays come out that can obviate or supplant the need for an invasive tissue biopsy. So liquid biopsies are a complement in most cases, but actually can replace a tissue biopsy in other cases. So this is an important advance for patients diagnosed with cancer. Now, we do have unique technology that informs these decisions, and in fact, we have 71 patents issued around our technology. And the testing is actually done in our own lab where I'm at right here today and where we've been throughout the pandemic because we've been doing COVID testing. And so this is in San Diego. We have specimens from all over the world, mostly from the U.S. And we perform them right here with our very hardworking team here in the laboratory. So first about COVID testing, then we'll spend the rest of the time talking about our important oncology offerings. But in COVID testing, like I say, it truly is paying the bills. We recently announced we've done 570,000 COVID tests now since we launched in July. We get paid about $100 for each one. So this has turned into a lucrative opportunity for us. And the important part is it's providing the funding for our investment in our future oncology clinical strategy. Now, when you look at what we're doing, it's PCR testing. And our turnaround time is very fast. Most of our client base is in the skilled nursing arena, but we also help the Community College Foundation, which we recently had news on. And in fact, it's been kind of a big peak, as people know, as the pandemic kind of took off back last fall, and then it started to come back down in Q2, and now all of a sudden, because of Delta, we're very busy again. In fact, the last time we reported an update, about once a month, we try to report our volumes on COVID for folks so they get an idea of how things are going. We've done about 500,000 back in mid-August. Then last week in mid-September, we announced it was 570,000, so 70,000 in just 1 month. So very busy right now with COVID testing. So you can see this volume growth here on this slide as we've gone up, and we talked about the reimbursement, how that's turned into real revenue. So getting to our core strategy, which is oncology, you know, Biocept's focused on this continuum you see in front of you in liquid biopsy at the first two boxes, diagnosis and therapy selection and response and monitoring for progression. We hope the patient's doing better, and we see the quantitative results go down in these patients, but sometimes they go up if the patient's doing worse. But that's called monitoring, and you would do that routinely over and over on a patient. In the future, we'll get into recurrence monitoring and perhaps someday even in screening, which are all exciting, important initiatives where liquid biopsy has a play. So the advantage is the ability to capture these cells out of the specimen. I know we just have 15 minutes, so I'm zipping through pretty quickly. The same deck is on our website, so you can review it in a lower way. We also have much more sensitive assays that actually get the sensitivity down to 0.05%. Many other tests are only at 1% or 0.1%, so we can find things others do not. And our branded test, and what's the most exciting offering that we have right now, is called CNSide. And that's actually a play on words. It stands for central nervous system, which is means your brain and all your nervous system. And so the cancer metastasizes, spreads to that area, unfortunately, as the cancer becomes much more aggressive. And so that's what the CNS stands for, central nervous system. But we're also helping the physician see inside what's going on with these results. So that's what that means. So this is our workflow. I'm not going to spend a lot of time on that today, except to say that even the blood collection tube is proprietary to BioSep. It's a standard vacutainer tube, but the media inside preserves the specimen for up to 4 days. So we have time to FedEx it here. We have time to get it processed in the lab that way. In addition, we have time to even get specimens through customs from overseas that come our way. These are examples of actual cancer cells we've isolated and interrogated. And that information all gets then reported back to the referring physician, and they use that to make treatment decisions for their patients. So this is a great slide because it kind of just shows you what we're looking at. And so these are the tumor cells that are in blood or they're present in CSF, as you see in this diagram here, as well as cell-free fractions. So sometimes when the cells break down, the nucleic acid is released, and then cell-free DNA is in there. We're able to isolate and interrogate that as well. So there's really three critical questions we're answering when it comes to CNSide. And this is, once again, the ability to do the CSF testing, the cerebral spinal fluid testing, to say, is there cancer present? So that's the first question. Is there tumor? And then, in fact, you see a cell over here that would indicate, yes, there is a tumor in that specimen we just got. Number two, is there a target to inform treatment decisions? So these little dots you see are examples of how we do the testing, that we look for certain genes that means you can get on a targeted therapy. One of the most well-known targeted therapies, you see if you watch football, I'm a Kansas City Chiefs fan, being from Kansas City, so I do, you see Keytruda advertisements from Merck. And at the end of that, the guy will say, hey, Keytruda's indicator for people that have an overexpression of PD-L1. And so he'll say that real fast, just like I did. Well, that is the biomarker, PD-L1. And so we look for that biomarker as well as many others. There's a lot of biomarkers, a lot of drugs, such as Herceptin from Genentech, Tagrisso from AstraZeneca. You have to have this biomarker to get on those drugs. So we look for those biomarkers to find out the best treatment for the patient. Finally, is there a trend? So we monitor this over time. We hope the patient does better and their cells go down over time, but sometimes they go up. But we hope to see them go down. That's the 1-2-3 approach with CNSide. So I'm going to skip forward a few slides. This is always meaningful, I think, to show how we're really helping patients. So this is a mother of two. She's in her 40s. It's a real patient. We're continuing to follow her. And her specimen showed up on BioSep back in July of last year in the middle of the pandemic. At that point, she had about 30,000 cancer cells in that specimen. That's just in a little 8 ml vial of cerebral spinal fluid. We found that she had a HER2 amplification, meaning she's a candidate for Herceptin therapy. So her physician put a little port right into her skull. The cannula goes right down into her brain. They infused the Herceptin right into her brain. And in fact, you can see she responded. This is awesome. So without what we had done, she very well could have just been sent to hospice and would be no longer with us today. So instead, because when you get metastatic cancer to your brain from your breast cancer, in her case, it very often is in stage. But in this case, there was something her doctor was able to do about it, we found. And you can see her tumor cell counts came down month after month, and she stayed in remission. She's still in remission today and doing well on treatment. So this is a huge advantage. Everyone at BioSep's excited about all these cases we see. I encourage you to review, if you have an interest, a webinar we have on our website where we have various big industry KOLs. These are folks at Yale, at Northwestern, and at Barrow's Neurological Institute in Phoenix. These are neuro-oncologists, key opinion leaders, who are high on our test and advocating the use for their patients. So this tells you why. Well, the current standard of care only gives them a result between 40 and 50% of the time generally. We're finding results 75 to 80%. So in other words, doing much better than the standard of care, that sensitivity in action. We will be launching a trial next year, so more to come on that. So stay tuned for news as we launch our 4C trial, where we compare the standard of care to the standard of care plus our test, CNSide. And that will lead to, we hope, high-value reimbursement and adoption in the guidelines in the future is our goal. So it's a big market, as I said, and you can see here how the numbers roll up. So this is important to understand as you look at that. And there's about 200,000 patients per year that have metastatic cancer that progresses to the central nervous system. So when you look at monitoring plus diagnosis, it's a very sizable market. Here's our strategy to become the standard of care. As I said, engage these KOLs, as well as go on through our studies, get more data out there. As we get CNSide into the guidelines is our hope, so it's done for every late-stage cancer patient. Now, health plans are paying for this because being able to better manage the patient is always more efficient than wasting money and resources on a therapy that's not working. So we've been able to get quite a few contracts. In fact, we're partners with the Blue Cross Association and proud of that, as well as gotten numerous of the Blue Cross agreements. Now, I do have salespeople all around the country working very hard. We have about 12 of them working very hard out there. And we've got now people ordering the test from about 30 of the top academic institutions. A lot of collaborations, and one notable on this slide that I do want to tell you about is with Quest. A lot of excitement in the investors when they saw that announcement earlier this year that we had signed the deal. That's still scheduled to go live, by the way, in Q4. So stay tuned. We'll make an announcement when it does go live. We're in the process of integrating the computer, so it's easy for Quest to order that. And we'll be marketing our non-small cell lung cancer blood-based assay, in this case, through the Quest oncology sales team. So we're very excited about that. A lot of patents, about 71 patents on what we do. Very experienced leadership team. We all have at least 24 years of experience in diagnostics, and in some of this case, over 30 years. In some cases, over 40 years experience. So we've done this before successfully, and we're excited about doing it here at BioCept as well. The world-class board of directors, and I also encourage you, if you do review this on our website, make sure you look up these folks' names, our clinical advisory board. You'll see they're on the guidelines committee, and these are true opinion leaders that oncologists rely on to help inform their own treatment paradigm. So we're excited to have them as part of BioCept as our advisory board. As you see, this is our year versus year growth, and you can see we've grown a lot because of the COVID revenue, which we see right there. So a little drop like I talked about for the COVID volume as the pandemic subsided a little bit earlier this year. Once Delta came back, the numbers have gone up as we've been reporting. So my final slide, our corporate priorities, drive adoption of our lead product, CNSide. Position CNSide as the standard of care for diagnosis and monitoring of central nervous system involvement. Initiate that trial by Q2 of next year. Expand CNSide testing with additional tumor types. In fact, we have breast cancer and lung cancer validated today. We'll be validating melanoma as well as a pan cancer offering as well in the coming months. Increase sales of all of our products. Entering into more and more additional partnerships, such as we've done with Quest. Secure Medicare payment for one of our assays. We have Medicare payment for most of them, but one we've been working on in partnership with a large company called Thermo Fisher. We hope to get that in the near future, as well as growing sales through our Quest relationship. So with that, happy to answer a few questions.
Really good stuff, Mike. I do have a couple questions here for you. So you just hinted at the types of cancer that CNSide you want to expand toward, but give us a little bit of insight about how you plan to reach the broader oncology community.
Oh, yeah, no, that's a great question. As I said, right now we're focused on what's called neuro-oncology. But if you're not in oncology, folks might not understand there's like subspecialties in oncology as you go through the cancer care continuum and eventually become a survivor. I actually have experience in that myself. So neuro-oncology are oncologists who specialize in cancer that's metastasized to the central nervous system brain. They also treat primary brain tumors. So someday in the future, we'll actually be focused as well on primary brain tumors as they're eager for us to get there. But when you look at the 200,000 patients that I talked about that have metastatic cancer that progresses to their brain, a large amount of those are in the two types of cancer we've already validated, lung and breast. Next most common is melanoma to go to the brain, and then after that is everything else. So that's kind of our way we're doing it. We're starting with the neuro-oncologists because they're seen as the experts and the thought leaders in cancer that does progress to the nervous system. Sure. Once we get them on board, as we are doing now, we plan then to go to the broader medical oncology community. And that'll be on to mid-year next year is the target for that.
Gotcha. Okay. And from our chat here, we have a question on the Quest Diagnostics relationship. Timing for that. Can you speak to, you know, when Quest will begin marketing?
Yeah. We're still scheduled for Q4. So as I said, okay. We made the announcement. We signed the agreement earlier in the spring, and we're in the process you know, with this, with Quest, you need to be integrated into their own ordering system so folks can order the tests. And also, we get the order from them. Our reports go into their system and then go to the client. So that's being finalized right now. As soon as that's done, we'll be ready to go and get their salespeople trained.
Great stuff. And I think we would be remiss, I would be remiss not to ask about the COVID side of things. Sure. Any concern with, you know, you hinted at business for the COVID testing started picking up again when Delta started popping up. But, I mean, any concern as we are now getting back into school, any concern for, like, an influx of need for COVID testing due to kids being back at school?
Well, that's what we've seen. And one of the things that we announced earlier this year that now we're really seeing the volume increase from is that we were one of four labs chosen for the community college system in California. That's 2.1 million students, faculty, and staff.
Okay.
And they're using us at many of the campuses here in Southern California. We actually put little tents there for swabbing. And we, you know, access the specimens for all the unvaccinated. It's required once a week for all the unvaccinated employees and students. So those specimens come to us from LA, San Diego, Riverside, a lot of the different community college campuses. So, you know, that plus the Delta is why you're seeing this spike in our volume.
And no issues with the team handling the capacity?
No, we built that. And, you know, the other piece about that, and I'm glad you brought that up, because it's not what we've built for COVID. We all hope COVID gets under control.
Certainly.
No longer
certainly.
This in the future. We don't see that anytime soon. We've evolved our thinking. Who knew last year we thought we'd be out of this by now. But sure. Now it looks like this is going to come and go as we maintain, you know, for these different strains. But the investments we made are good for our oncology side too. It's all the same equipment, staffing. And in fact, when you do the volume we're doing, where we're doing tens of thousands, you know, a week, we have to have automation. Before, with our liquid biopsy testing, we were relatively small volume. We had a lot of manual processes. We've now moved to almost full automation. When somebody, for example, orders a test, instead of handwriting a requisition like we used to with the oncology, now it's all on the computer. That comes into us. There's a barcode at the client side. That goes on the specimen. Comes in here. We wand it. Then it gets automatically put into our lab as well as with automation. Then on the backside, reports go up in an automated way without somebody having to manually upload a PDF or something like that. So this has all been automated. This will only help me with my oncology, with my relationship with Quest. So a lot of these investments that we've made because of COVID will really pay off for BioCep in the future years as well.
Excellent. So I just want to reiterate how you said it earlier was, you know, the COVID testing paid the bills, but you're highlighting that there are absolutely direct benefits to that.
Oh, absolutely. It's provided this revenue source we didn't have before to invest in our core strategy. You want to invest in the clinical trial. There's a lot of ways we're using the revenues from COVID along the way. So we're thankful for the investors we've had and they continue to have to get us there and hope that they see the value in the way they're helping provide this needed service for folks over here in the West Coast. And actually, we have specimens from all over America.
Certainly. Well, it was a pleasure learning a little bit about BioCep and having a little bit of a conversation with you, Mike. Mike Knell, he is president and CEO of BioCep. It's ticker BIOC on the NASDAQ. Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you, Brent. Good to see you.
Yes, sir. Have a good day. Until next time.